Welcome, and thank you for taking the time to view a short presentation from Avatech. Here to present is Ken Rose from our data management team.
Thank you for the introduction. This presentation will cover the benefits of using batch plot within Productstream. Typically, the need to generate paper prints occurs somewhere within every design process. Here, I've outlined the popular tasks that CAD operators and engineers support within their duties. And although printing may take place at each of these stages, the largest effort is associated with the release cycle. Plotting has proven to become a very troublesome task for many design and manufacturing companies. However, these companies have come to accept the additional delays at the end of a project when it comes time to generate paper prints. That's because it has traditionally been a task for designers and engineers to perform at the end of each project, a task that can take anywhere from 30 minutes to several hours to complete. A few steps here are outlined, and this is just scratching the surface as to where the time is spent with plotting tasks. Manually locating each drawing, opening each file inside of AutoCAD or Inventor, printing the drawing, and repeating until finished. Of course, nobody likes to deal with the afterthoughts of manually tracking which drawings have already been printed versus what still needs to be printed, or issues where prints have been missed altogether. I should mention that going paperless with a data management environment is the only way to ultimately avoid these bothersome plotting tasks. But for workflows that have issues transitioning to a paperless process, plotting is very much a large issue. To address this task, Autodesk Productstream has the ability to provide intelligent batch plotting. Batch plotting within Productstream can either be initiated for a new task, or existing jobs can be repulled and plotted again. Either method pulls the latest known print. Before I begin the demonstration, I've outlined the batch plotting tasks into three easy steps. Step 1, determine which option to use when populating the plot list. Here, we'll have the options to include files on a 1x1 basis, per folder, per assembly, per item, or per bill of material. And yes, we can combine more than one of these options to get our final list. Step 2, make your selections and watch the plot list populate. And finally, step 3, to simply run the task. After that, the person running the batch plot task can get back to doing design work and moving on to other tasks. If curious, a plot progress monitor can be viewed to show the completed, active, and remaining plot tasks. People have also found it beneficial to have the ability to rerun a previously created plot list. Plus, there's no need to be concerned about what will be sent to the printer, because Productstream will always pull the latest known drawing. Now, let's take a look at the batch plot demonstration. What we have here on the left-hand side of the screen is an expert Inventor user plotting a job within native Inventor, whereas the right-hand side of the screen is plotting the same job, but using Productstream. To make sure these screen recordings end at the same time, I had to accelerate the video on the left by 860%. Let's see how this plays out. On the left-hand side, the user is trying to leverage the parts list that appears on the drawing. Then each drawing has to be manually located, manually opened, and then sent to the plotter. On the right-hand side of the screen, we're at the stage where the assembly was searched on, and all of the detailed drawings that are associated with that assembly are being automatically pulled and populate the plot list now. On the left-hand side, we're still chugging through, trying to keep track of which prints we've already sent versus the prints that still remain to be sent. On the right-hand side, the plot has already occurred, and we're watching the progress monitor complete. In the end, both methods got the same results, but the manual method took nearly 9 times as long. What we just saw was an amazing way to reduce the time spent on a very common engineering task. In my example, it takes between 8 to 9 times as long to perform the same exact task when we compare using Productstream for batch plotting and using nothing. These types of time savings are the highest among some of the available gains associated to process improvements. I was also able to have a better understanding of what needed to be included in my print package. I didn't forget any prints, and I always pulled the latest drawing. With the option to choose between plotting the native CAD file or using the lightweight DWF file, it makes sense to choose the smaller, faster DWF file. And ultimately, our goal for using batch plot is that we achieve some sort of payback, whether it's to save time, reduce errors, or simply to save money by significantly reducing such a time-consuming task. Any justification described will see payback. Please look on our website for additional demonstrations and white papers regarding data management products. Thank you.
Thank you, Ken. Once again, Avatech would like to thank you for your time. Please direct any remaining questions to the email address pdm@avatech.com.